Welcome all of you to this demo session on Fusion's procure to pay life cycle. Actually, fine. So we are going to have a look at it, and then we'll be comparing with the EBS at every stage. The real training starts on 8:30 a.m. on Sunday morning, India time. And then before which, what happens? I would like to give you what's called a demo on this now. So let me go and then share my screen and then start to do the activities on this now. So at any point in time, whenever you have any doubt, what happens, you please ask me then and there. So then only what happens, I can understand your questions now. Fine, go there. So let me first of all go there and then log in into the system now. So when you log in, what happens, you'll be having a URL. I'll be giving you this URL. It's a release 12 URL actually. So let me go there and then log in now. Fine. So I'm now putting an username and then a password. So with the username and password, I'm going to sign in now. So the moment you sign in, what happens, you'll be landing up in a page called, what happens, the springboard now. Fine, I will not go there. So this is actually what's called, if you click on the home icon on the left-hand side top, what happens, you will now come into the page called springboard now. This is called a springboard. And then here, what happens, they are equivalent to menus now. Fine, the sales is a menu. Fine, if you click on the menu, and then you can now see so many sub-icons are there. Fine, we can even call them as a sub-menus now. Fine, they are analogous to menus and sub-menus of eBiz basically. And then what happens, the user himself can personalize the screens. Right? Let us say the sales menu is there. It has got, what happens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 sub menus are there. He will now click on the right hand side icon now. Fine, click on it. One second. The recording icon is not there. One second. Stop sharing. Okay, recording is there actually. I will not share the screen now. Are you able to see the recording icon there in your place? On the left hand side top. The recording icon is visible now for you.
Sir, it's recording.
Recording, yeah. So now here, what happens if you go there? If you click on the sales, what happens? You've got some 6 sub-menus are there. Let us say, I don't want territories to be there on this one. Fine. I will now click on the right-hand side. A personalized springboard icon is there. If we click on it, what happens? It will now say, here, what happens? I will now remove on the sales. What happens? The territories, I will now remove the tick mark and then click on OK on the right-hand side. By which, what happens? The territory will go away. If you click on it, the territories is gone. The territory is nowhere there now. Right? So likewise, what happens, the end user can customize the springboard now. If you don't want sales itself, what happens, you will not click on it. And then here, what happens, you will not remove the sales itself. Not okay. The sales itself can be removed. So this is a springboard which can be customized by the end user himself. Now. Apart from that, on the left-hand side, what happens, you'll be having a thing called a navigator icon. If you click on the navigator icon, what happens, you can now see the entire thing coming up now. So to configure this, what happens, we need a help of technical now. Fine. So this can be configured only because technically, if you want to remove any menus or sub-menus, what happens, we need technical assistance, because what happens, they'll be creating a sandbox by which, what happens, they will now customize the navigator actually. Whereas springboard can be done, fine. When, what happens, when he logs in, what happens, it will be having a, what happens, equal. The springboard and navigators will be equal. And then afterwards, based upon the individual customization, what happens, it will be all be changing now. So when you log in, what happens, you land up in the area called springboard, in which what happens, you'll be having menus and submenus. So they are all maybe equivalent to your functions also. It may be not be a submenu, it may even be a function as such. And then here what happens, you'll have sysadmin now. Fine, click on this left hand side icon. Here what happens, I can go to the system administrator. If you go down the bottom, what happens, you can now see one more icon is there. You click on the more icon. From there, what happens, we go into the security console. Fine, you go to the security console. I will now maximize the screen, the F11 now. F11 will now maximize the screen, function key F11. And then from there, what happens, I go there. I click on the more icon, and then I go to the security console. Now. There is a bottom link for the security console. This is equivalent to sysadmin of EBIS, basically. Security console of EBIS. Here, what happens, I'm now going to create a, what happens, a user now. So let me go and then create a user now. So I will now go to the second tab region. The first tab region is a role. Second tab region is a user. So let me go and then get a user now. Fine. Click on add user account. So I'm going to add a user account. You know, fine. Go there. First name. I will now put my name here. Ananta. And then the last name is Nana. I go there. Email. I will now put nana.app60@gmail.com. In EBIS, what happens through sysadmin, we can only create a user, but not the employee. Here, what happens, even the employees also can be created. So employee name, first name and last name, email, and then the username also created. The system coins the username as what? First name dot last name. So what happens, I'm going to remove the, what happens, Ananta dot, what happens, Nana Fine, I'm going to remove it now. Fine, that I will now say Ananta. The dot, I'm going to remove it now. Fine, you can even customize whichever you want now. Fine, I will now make it as only Ananta, whatever it is. And then I'm going to give a password. So I'm now giving a password of Oracle 123 init caps. Fine, go there. And then I will now confirm it now. And here, our password doesn't expire. Fine. In EBIS, what happens? The password is created upon first login, it will be expiring it. And then here, the entire system is role based access control. And then what happens? I go there, click on the add role at the bottom now. If I click on add role, and then I'm remembering the passwords also. Fine, I'm going to add it. Fine. IT security manager is basically what happens is a sysadmin role. I'm giving a sysadmin role now, IT security manager. And there are multiple things are there. I'm going to choose the Vora one now. Vora one is having the maximum powers. Fine, click on add role membership. Click on add role membership, by which what happens is now getting added now. Fine, go there. So it is now added. And then I will now add one application implementation consultant, which is nothing but a setup role now. Fine. It is a setup role, application implementation consultant. Fine. This role facilitates you to do the setups now. Fine. Here everything is role based. I will now choose this role. Fine. Click on add membership. He's having these two roles. And then I will now add one abstract role called employee now. Fine. Employee is an abstract role. I'm now going to add one employee as abstract role. Go there. I will now add it now. Click on add membership to the role. Fine, that's it. I'm not going to give these three roles to the user now. Fine, go there. So the username is Ananta, and then what happens? You will now be able to log into the system now. And remember, right, if you create a user in sysadmin, what happens? He is not eligible to do any procurement activity at all. Fine. In EBIS, if you go on and see, if you go there, if you go to sysadmin now, fine. If you go to sysadmin, go to the end now. I'm not going to create a user now. Fine, go to the security user define. I will not query. So this user, I will not say the first user is going to come, find down arrow. I will not say 111 cannot access procurement at all. Can anybody tell me why it's so? Why 111 cannot access procurement? Even though if I give a responsibility of, let us say, purchasing responsibility, I'm giving it, then also you cannot access it. Anybody?
He should be defined as a buyer.
Not buyer. Buyer is only for the purchase order, but he cannot even touch a requisition also. Why it's so?
Worker. Person name has to be attached.
Worker. The person is not there. Fine. The user employee association is missing. What happens? He cannot do any activity on purchasing at all. Fine. So here, similarly, it's so. Here also, what happens? When you create a, what happens? A employee or a user. Fine. Employees and users both can be created from sysadmin as well as in HRMS. Fine. In HRMS also, we can create a user and employee. In sysadmin also, we can create a user and employee. But users who are created via sysadmin cannot do any activity on purchasing at all. Fine. That's what it is. So you go and then give a save and close, maybe what happens, the user creation is not complete. Now we'll go and then create an item now for the procure to pay lifecycle now. So I'm now saving it. So I just demoed it about how to create a user now. Fine, go there. I will now click on the home icon. I will now click on the home icon. And then from there, what happens, I'm now going to create an item. I will now go to the product management. And then from there, what happens, I'll now go into the product information management. Click on the product information management. So here, what happens, I'm now going to create an item now. For this exercise, product management, product information management, it will now go to the next one. On the right hand side, what happens? You'll be able to see task carousel now. Fine. This is called a task carousel now. Fine. It is now collection of tasks actually. Fine. Click on it now. And then here, what happens from there? I'm now going to create item. So click on create item. I'm now going to create an item now. Click on create item. And then here, what happens in EBIS when you go there, when you want to create an item, fine. What happens? You have to first of all choose an R. Fine, go there, go to inventory. And then in the inventory, what happens, you go there. And then you'll know, first of all, change the organization to your working organization. So I'm going to change the organization to M1 now. Fine. And then afterwards, when you go to items, master items, the M1's master will now open up. Fine. M1's master is V1 now in the vision. Fine. The M1's master organization will open up. Double click. What happened? The M1's master organization. Here, it is not so. If you go and then see, here what happens, I will now have only the master logs listed over here now. M010. The master, fine. So you can't have any other. The child dogs will not be listed over here. Only the master will be listed over here. Now, fine, go there. And then what happens? The PIM has been integrated along with the what happens Fusion. And so what happens? We have to have a root item class. Even though we don't do anything on the root item class, what happens is the mandatory one. So it is now getting added up. So like in EBIS, what happens? The discrete and process manufacturing have been clubbed in R12. So here, what happens? The PIM and then the inventory have been clubbed in Fusion actually. And then go there. And then here at the bottom, what happens? We go there. There is a template there. It is equivalent to our template of EBIS. Now, fine. Go and then apply.
Sorry to interrupt. What is that item class? Root item class?
The root item class is for the product information management module. You know PIM in EBIS. It is exactly the same thing. Fine. In PIM also, what happens? We'll be having a root item class.
Okay.
So, PIM needs a root item class, whereas inventory do not need it. But since it is a mandatory, we have to populate that.
Okay. And you are creating this item in the master organization, not in the inventory organization.
The master is a master inventory org only. Fine. The master inventory org. Afterwards, I'll be assigning it to a child inventory org.
Okay.
I'm creating the master. Fine. Go there. You know, given. So I now brought the template to the right hand side and then click on OK by which what happens the template gets applied. And then what happens? I will now give what happens the item number. Fine. I will now say test underscore item one. Fine. It is a what? It is a test item one. Test item. Go there. So I go down and then afterwards what happens? I go there. I can even click on the specifications. In the specifications area, if you see what happened, there are 7 areas are available here. Fine. Manufacturing, service, inventory, everything is there. So in EBIS, what happens? We have got around 16 tab regions. They have been clubbed into 7 tab regions over here. And these 16 tab regions have been clubbed into 7 tab regions. I go to the purchasing area and then here what happens? I'm going to give the list price now. Fine. Go to the list price. I'll not make it as 3 now. Fine. That will now get defaulted onto the requisitions as well as purchase orders. In EBIS, what happens after you fill up? You fill up something, and then what happens? Go to the tools, and then go to the copy from, and then you apply a template now. Right? Purchase item template is now getting applied. Then go there. Afterwards, what happens? You go to the purchasing, and then give a list price, and then you submit it. After you save it, what happens? You go to the tools, and then go to the organization assignment to assign it. Now. Fine. Here it is not so. So before saving itself, you can assign it. Fine. You go to the associations, and then I'm going to associate a child out. I will now click on the actions and then click on select an act point. Now what happens in the associations, what happens, it has to be, you go there, go to the actions and then select an ad is not coming. One second. Okay.
To select it seems, that line you have to select it seems.
Yeah, test item 1-1, I will now make it now. Fine, it was already there. Test item 1-1, I will now make it now. Because the already item is existing and so what happens, it's not allowing me to put the item over here now. Okay, fine, test item 1-1 is also existing. Fine, I will now say 1-2-3. I'll now put 1-2-3 over here now. So that it has accepted now. Fine, go there. So item has been accepted. Fine, go down. So what happens? You are now given the specification. And then what happens? You go to actions and then go to select an add. Go there, select an add. And then let me assign it to a child or no. Go there. It's capital M 011 is the item. Fine, click on query. I'm now going to query it now. So let me query it now. So select it and then click on apply and done, by which what happens is now getting assigned. So we can assign the item to the child org and then afterwards save also. There we have to save it and then assign it. You go there and then click on save. I will now save and close. So test underscore item 1-2-3 is now ready. Now I'm going to create a purchase requisition for this now. I'll go there. So it is now completed. Whenever you have any doubts, what happens? You open up your mic and then speak then and there. Now I click on it. So let me go and then create a purchase requisition now. Click on the home icon. And then I go to the procurement now. You go to the procurement area. And then here what happens? I go to the purchase requisitions now. So let me create a purchase requisition for this now. I'll be creating a purchase requisition. Here what happens? I go there. Click on the requisition line entry on this area. This area what happens? I'm going to click on the requisition line entry. And then let me create a requisition now. So test underscore item 1-2-3 is an item. So which I'm going to do it now. Fine, go there. Item is test underscore. What happens? Item 1-2-3. Fine. Now selected. I will now go for 10 quantities on this now. So go there. I will now what happens? I will now remove the right hand side already recently added item. I will now remove it. And then let me add this item again. Fine, 10 quantities on this now. Fine, click on add to requisition. So it's of $3 each now. Can you see? Okay, I don't know. It does not come. It's now $30 over there. Click on edit and submit, and then here it comes to this place for approval. So 10, 10 quantities at $3 each, which are given as a list price in the item. Fine. Now, what happens before I submit for approval? Let me make it as an automatic approval. So let me open up one more tab region in which what happens? I will now set up the approvals actually. Click on this, I will now go to the setup and maintenance area. You click on the setup and maintenance area. What happens? You have to run a task now. It's called manage requisition approval. So manage rec percentage app percentage. Fine, you can even give a short form like this and then enter it. So on the setup and maintenance area, I'm now running a task called manage requisition approvals. I click on it now and then I'm going to set it up to automatic now. Fine, let me parallel because there are 6 methods of approval available here in EBIS. What happens? We have only the supervisor hierarchy and position hierarchy here. There are 6 methods of approval. It is very well in that. And then AME is inbuilt on this now. Fine, AME is not separate, AME is inbuilt on this now. So it's not disabled. Fine, go there. I will now click on edit rules now. I click on edit rules. And then here what happens? Let me have only one automatic over there now. 133 rule is there. It's automatic approval or not.
Nana, can you compare this with the EBS, like we'll set up the approval groups and approval assignments,
yes,
right?
This cannot be done today. My class is only a demonstration session now.
Oh, okay.
Right? A long time. We are going to have a 25-hour session in which what happens, everything will be explained over there.
Okay.
It will be still parallelly compared everywhere. Fine.
You'll okay.
Comparison everything. Fine. Now okay. I am now setting up only an automatic approval. You'll not see the approval comparisons everywhere. Fine. It's only automatic. So everything, other things has been disabled now. Fine. Only thing is now. And click on save, and then we have to deploy also. Deploying is nothing but freezing and compiling. I'm not going to deploy it. So, you know, freezing and compiling it now. Fine, go there. So the person who is developing this application is known as an application developer. And then what happens? He himself can approve it now. Fine. So here what happens? The approval is nothing but a list building mechanism. It will now build the list of approvers who are going to approve it now. So what happens is the list building mechanism by which it will be coming. Fine. You have to wait for some time. It will be running a concurrent for what happens is compiling it actually. So once when it is completed, what happens, you go there. And then if you click on the manage approvals, it will not show you who is going to approve it now. Fine. So what happens, there are so many other things. The descriptive flux fields have been enabled. So we are enabled to enter all the values over here now. I'm going to say Tamil Nadu and then go there. Some descriptive flux fields have been done now. So they're all mandatory fields. And so what happens, it needs it now. Fine, go there. I will now give a save now on this. So 10 quantities of three prices, what happens, I will not click on the manage approvals, it will not show you who is going to approve it now. The person who has developed this requisition is known as an application developer, and then he himself is going to approve. So 101 the requisition number, yeah.
No, sorry for this interrupting you. Actually, you are saying that some concurrent program is running in the background, right? How will you see that program?
Some of them will be hidden. I will not show you. Find the concurrent program once again. And then go there. So we can see the concurrent programs via what happens, you click on the navigator icon, and then here what happens, you go there, and then you go to the more icon on the right hand side, and then here what happens, you go to the scheduled process. Fine, go to the scheduled process. This is one. So click on the scheduled process. This is nothing but a concurrent program. Fine, some of them will now run in the foreground, some of them will be running in the background now.
In EBS, we can see view request, right?
Exactly.
This way, how we can see.
It is equivalent to view request. Fine. Tools view request, fine. This is something. Okay. It's not showing in the front end. What happens is not running in the back end. Now, fine, go there. Now it shows what application developer has to approve. That means what he himself can approve it. It is an automatic approval. I'll now click on submit 1019. I'm submitting for approval, by which what happens, the requisition is now approved. It will not take some time for it. Now let us go there. In EBIS, what happens? We have a what's called auto criteria for processing it. Now, fine, go there. Such responsibility to what happens the purchasing now. In the purchasing, what happens, you'll be having auto criteria. So in the auto criteria, when you want to query, what you do is, first of all, you will now clear all the data because the buyer, the shipped location, everything has to be clear. So in Fusion also, what happens, we have to clear first of all and then put your requisition upon the query. So what happens, you go there. I will now go to the purchase orders now. Fine, go to the purchasing tab. Right? From here itself, you can go now. Fine, go there. Click on the task carousel on the right hand side. Here, what happens, you go there. Go to the process requisitions. So click on the process requisition now. Click on the process requisition. Here, what happens? You clear everything. The buyer, I'm clearing it. 1019 is a requisition now. 1019 is a requisition. Click on search now. I'm searching it now. So 1019 searching, it is now selected. Fine. Over there. I will now select it, and then what happens? I'm now going to convert it into a what? Yeah, purchase order now. Fine. Go there. So one second. I will now search for it. Process requisition is coming. What happens? I'm not going to go there. Actions. What happens? Add to document builder. So we are going to add it to the document builder now. Fine. Go to actions and then go to add to document builder. I'm going to add it now. I'm adding it to your document builder. So in the document builder, what happens? If you have any automatic process by which what happens, you can even have a source agreement taken over it. So we can properly those things over here now. And there is no automation is not demonstrated over here now. If I click on OK, by which what happens, it will now, the information will be coming onto the right hand side now. From there, what happens, I'll now create a purchase order. Document builder is now added up now. In auto criteria also, what happens, you go there, click on find now. And then from there, what happens, you will now click on what happens, you go there. So once when you find up the data, you will now select the data and then click on automatic. And then it will now go to the document builder. From there, what happens? It will now finally go and then create a purchase order actually. So this is also in a similar fashion. You're going to have it now, fine. So here, what happens? You go there. In this place, in the document builder, what happens? You go there, click on it, and then click on create icon on the bottom now and create button. So by now, you got it now, fine. In this place, what happens? If you click on the automatic, when you click on the automatic, it goes to the next stage called the document builder. Fine, this is the document builder. And then if you click on create, what happens? The purchase order gets created. Fine, click on create. The purchase order gets created now. So it's also similar one, fine, go there. So what happens? The document purchase order has been created now, fine, go there. You know that. So for 10 quantities, everything has come. So I go there. I will now, you have got lines, schedules, and distributions. There, what happens is lines, shipments, and distributions. So I go to the what's called schedules, and then I give a date. Now. Date is a must now. Fine, go there. We have to give a date now. Fine, go there. The requested date is automatically coming from the requesters, from the requisition, basically. Fine, 24-1. And then what happens? You go there. I will now select it and then click on edit, and then I will now make the result routing a standard. So here also what happens is now happening now here. It's now created one. So here what happens? You go to the shipments and then you'll now give the dates now here. In this place, you'll now give the promised date or need by date. Since it's auto-created, what happens? The need by date is coming from the requesters. Fine, here also it's coming. Fine, here all of I go there. In the shipments, what happens? I go there and then I will now change it to standard result. Standard is a product. I make a change. Fine, go there. And then click on what happens. OK. And then I'm going to submit for approval. So this is also set for automatic. So 201 will not be submitted for approval. It will be going over there. Once again, I want to ensure that once again, you must provide a value for that. The supplier is not provided. So I have not even given a supplier. Supplier, I will not say M01. Is a supplier I'm going to give it to. Supplier and site were not populated. And then apart from that, what happens? You go down in this place. What happens? I will not go there. I will not edit it. I will not make it as a three-way result now. Fine. Select it and then click on edit now. I'm going to edit it. And then I'm going to make it as a three-way result now. Go down. So let me make it as a three-way result. Is now automatically coming over here now. Fine. Go there. And that is what it is. Go there and then click on OK. And then click on save. And then here, what happens? We have one validate icon is there. Fine. Click on save. And then you can validate it now. So upon good actions and then validate, it will not check everything, whether everything is okay or not. If the purchase order is not up, it will not say no errors are there. I will not submit it. So 2019 is going to be submitted. And then here you can even see the reference document over here now. Fine. The reference document will be coming over here now. So 1019 is not coming. Fine. There's a requisition number. It's not coming over here. There's a requisition. And go there. Let me submit it now. Fine. 2019, I'm submitting for approval. So 2019 will be submitted for approval, by which whatever the purchase order gets up. Now let us go and then receive it in the gate. So 2019 is now submitted for approval. I click on the home icon and then I go to the warehouse operations now. I click on the home icon. I will now click on the warehouse operations. And then from there, what happens? I will now go and then make a result. Fine, go to the results now. Click on the results. This area, there's a gate result actually. Fine, click on result now. So the gate, I'm going to receive 2019 now. And then I have to put the organization now. Fine, it is capital M011. There is a child organization. I have to put it. So once when you choose the organization over here, it will be coming on the right hand side of this place. I will now click on the task carousel and then I will now click on what your receive expected shipments for 2019. Click on it. So 2019, I'm going to be top and 2019 at your tab. And then click on search now. I'm going to search for it now. It will not show you this now. It is a standard result routing. So I have to receive and then deliver also. So now what happens, I have to give a date which is now beyond 3 days now. Fine, make it as null and then make a query now. Due date is null, so click on search now. So once when you search for it, it will be available. Select it and then click on receive. The 10 quantities I'm going to receive totally. Click on receive now. So what happens, I will now put the quantity as 10 now. 10, and then what happens, the receiving section, right? We cannot give a sub inventory over here. Click on create, by which what happens, we need creating a GRN. Fine, click on submit, which whatever the GRN gets created now. Fine. So 2019, the GRN gets created for the 10 quantities. So you must provide the value for additional information because somebody is now configuring the what's called the descriptive information now. Descriptive flux field, they are configuring it now. Fine, expand it. And then here, whatever the expiry date is a mandatory one. I will not give a submit by which what happened the GRN will be created. So 2019 is a PO for which the GRN number is 1016. Fine, click on OK. Now I have to put away. In EBIS, we call them as what happens receiving transactions there. So here it is known as a put away. So they are now making it in line with warehouse management system. I will now click on the task carousel and then here what happens, I go there. I will now make a put away of this what happens 1016 GRN number. Click on it. The result number is 1016 and then give a tap and then click search more. You're searching it and then select it and then click on put away. I'm going to make a put away now. So click on put away. I'm putting it away. So here what happens, you go there, select it, and then what happens, you know, with the sub inventory, everything is now coming automatically for you. I go there, click on submit, by which what happens, the 10 quantities will be put away. So what happens, it will be getting So we can even see the stock now. The put away transaction was created. Frankly, okay, I will now go to the inventory and then have a look at it. Go to the warehouse operations, go to the home icon, and then here, what happens? Go to the warehouse operations and then go to the inventory. Go to the inventory.
No, what is maybe put away receipts? What do you mean?
Is nothing but here, what happens if you go and then see in the EBIS now? Fine. In the EBIS, we have one receiving transaction there. You go to the receiving and then go to the receiving transactions. This is known as a put away. Delivered to the sub inventory. Fine. So that is known as a put away because that has been made in line with the warehouse management system. So warehouse management.
Like move orders.
Not move order. Move order is a different one. So if you go, this is the gate receipt and then this is a transaction which is now going to deliver the inventory into the inventory. Fine. There also
is nothing but delivery to the destination, right?
Of course, delivered to the destination. It is going to deliver to the destination. So that is known as a put away here. So go there. I will now put the item file test underscore. What is the name I have given here?
Item 123.
Test underscore item 123. Fine. Item 123. I give a tab. And then it will be coming. Fine. Click on search now. Find how much is there in the receiving, how much is there in inbound, everything will not show. Click on search. It will not show you. So this is equivalent to your material workbench of EBIS now. Fine. Expand it. It will not show you which organization and then which sub inventory does it receive. Fine. It will not show you. Now what happens? We'll now go and then go to the AP and then create an invoice now. Fine, go there. We'll now go to this place. Click on the home icon. Let me go to the AP and then create an invoice for 2019 PO now. I go to the what's called. You go to the payables now. Click on the invoicing. And click on invoice now. And remember, supply chain is not having any periods at all. No periods in supply chain. And so what happens? All the accounting will now take place only in financials. And then whether the period is open or not, you need not have to worry. You can just go on, keep on doing the transactions. As and when the setups are complete, what happens? No inventory periods, no purchasing periods, nothing is there. In fact, what happens? Supply chain management is not having any periods at all to open. Only financials module will be having a periods. I will now click on create. I'm not going to create invoice now. So it's so easy, very less cumbersome actually. So click on create now. So here what happens, you go there, I will now put the 2019 PO number now, give a tab, for which what happens, I'm not going to get invoice. So I have to choose my business unit M01 now. M01 is the one, so for which what happens, I'm not going to create it now, fine. I will now choose my M01 business unit. The business unit is equivalent to an operating unit now, but it's more powerful than what we have in EBIS. I will now put one number now, fine. It is a 2005. I'm not putting an invoice number. So its amount is 30. Right? Since the taxation is not there, what happens? It will be same. I will now obtain the line level distribution by a match. Right? Here, what happens in EBIS, if you go and then see, what happens? You have to do what? In the header level, you have to choose now. Right? In the payables area, if you go there, if you want to go into invoice now, you go there, go to the invoices, entry invoices. So here on the invoice header, what happens? You have to choose the appropriate one now, whether it is going to be a PO match or a receipt match. Now. If you make a wrong one, what happens? It will be difficult. Whereas here, it is automatic now. So there is no need for us to choose any match levels basically in Fusion now. It automatically chooses whether it is a PO match or a receipt match based upon the PO number. If I click on match now, click on the go line, click on the match invoice line, and then give a go. What happens? The matching will be automatic now. Fine. The business unit unit is not set up for process payments or missing. Okay, doesn't matter. Oh God, it's not coming as such now. It's not set up to process payments or missing a payment service provider. Fine. This is not configured for payments actually. And so what happens? We are unable to proceed further on this now. Fine. So the payment is not done. So only at this place, what happens? You can now obtain the line level invoice and then what happens? You can complete it actually. So, but it is not done. What happens? I'm unable to show on the further proceeding of this now. Fine. So this is on the invoice part. So now let us now push it into costing and then show it to you now. Fine. So here what happens? I have to go and then run the schedule new process. I'm not going to run the concurrent now. Schedule new process. Here what happens? I have to transfer the transactions into costing now. Fine. So transfer, fine. Transactions from receiving to costing and give a tab. So from transfer transactions from receiving to costing, and we'll do it now. So let me transfer the transaction from receiving to costing. So what happens? The accounting, the cost accounting will not take place now. Fine. Click on OK. I'm going to do it now. Fine. Click on OK. So from the date delivery, what happens? I'm now going to transfer it now. Transfer transactions from receiving to costing. And click on submit now.
In e-business, when you do receiving, automatically accounting take place. So here we need to do this separately.
Yeah. I'll show you in the e-business how it takes place now. Fine. In the EBIS, what happens if you go there, go to inventory, the accounting takes place automatically.
Yeah.
Go there. I'll show you. Fine. I'll now go to the transactions and then go to the what happens, the material transactions. will now query on another organization now. Say, let us say from 1st of February, will now query find, I'll now have some transactions now find go the query. So if you see any transactions file with this post bag, I'm going to create and click on the distributions. The accounting entries are automatically created. If you go to the type, what happens, you cannot see. The WIP valuation is now created and then the inventory valuation is now debited. Fine, this is not done. Whereas here, it is not so. So here, what happens is we have to push it into costing and then perform the valuation now, basically. The transactions has to be created now, fine, go there. So what happens is now running. So transfer transactions from, you know, receiving to costing is now running. So it has not succeeded. Now we'll now go to the costing area and then do it now, fine, go there. So let me go there and click on done. And then I will now go to the costing area and then perform the receiving transaction. So here, what happens if you go and then see this place, you will be one document which will be explaining on the P2P process now. Right? On the P2P process, if you see it now. So once when you perform a gate receipt, what happens, you cannot see, the receiving inspection account will be hit and then the contra entry is accrual account. Right? So that transactions will be made on the costing part now, on the costing area now. Right? Go there. So on the costing area, we'll be having it now. Right? Go there, the one. So I will now go to this area. I will now click on done and then come out of it. I will now go to the costing area. Frank, click on the home icon.
And is it like for all the inventory transaction, we have to post this costing separately each and every time?
Yes, not only for inventory, for every module. Like manufacturing also, you have to push it into costing. I have not transferred it from receiving to costing. Similarly, what happens from manufacturing also, you have to push it from payables, receivables, from everywhere. What happens, you have to push it to costing. So click on the receipt accounting. Right. I'm now going to create the receipt accounting distribution over here now. Let me go there and then create the receipt accounting distribution now. So go there, click on the task carousel, and then what happens, we'll now create it now. Fine. Click on create receipt accounting distributions. I'm going to make it now. So here, what happens, I will now say the built unit. Fine. Business unit is nothing but an operating unit now. Fine. It is M01. I will now give a tab. So it will now come automatically. Fine. Click on submit now. So by which, what happens, the receipt accounting is now getting created now. I will now go, it's not running. So you can now see on the monitor, what happens, the concurrent will be running for this now. Fine. Create receipt accounting distribution is now running. In the scheduled process, we can now see this now. So once when it is completed, what happens, you can now see the effort of it now, fine, go there, go to this place. I will now click on it, and then what happens, you know, review the receipt accounting distribution, click on the review receipt accounting distribution, I'm going to review it now. So click on it, and then the item number is what? It is a test underscore item, 123 is item, fine, give a tab. And then click on search now, I'm going to make a search on it. Fine, sorry, it's item 123. Fine, click on search now. So once when I search it, what happens, it will be finding the receipt accounting distribution coming over here. It has not come over here now, fine, go there. It's all done now. Fine. It's not showing you the PO number, as well as the GRN number, everything it will show you. And it will not show you the cost of this also. The ledger cost is now $3. If you go to the journal entries, what happens, is not done. So let us now do the receipt accounting and do the journal entries now. Fine. The journal entries not come. Fine. Let us now go there and then do the create accounting and then do it now. Fine, go there. So and then what happens, you go there and then go do the create accounting now. The task carousel, I'm now clicking on create accounting. Fine, here, what happens, this is now receipt accounting now. The subledger application is receipt accounting. Ledger is M01. Fine, give a tab. And then doing everything. Accounting mode is now draft. I will now make it now. Process all this thing. Fine, go there. Yeah. Now draft. And then it is now, what happens, I'll now make a detailed report. Fine, transfer to GL now because GL is not set here now. Fine, this one. I'll now make it as no now. So this much of an entry, what happens, I'm going to do it and I will now submit this now. Fine. I'm now performing a create accounting for a receipt accounting now. Fine, click on submit now. So 106 concurrent is now running. Fine, go there and then have a look at this now. So once when it is completed, what happens, you can now go and see this. Fine. Create accounting process is now running. So once when this is completed, what happens, you can now see on this place, the receipt accounting is now getting done. If you go there, go to this place, and then here, what happens? You click on done. You go there, and then now we again review it now. Fine, review receipt accounting distributions. Click on the review accounting distribution. Here, what happens? You go and then make a search again now. Expand the search, and then click on search again now. Then go there. And then the bottom, what happens? You'll now see on the what's called the journal entries. There is a problem here. It is not saying what happens. Subledger accounting was not able to look at a match for the mapping set receiving inspection for the input value. Fine. The account has not been given for the receiving inspection. So because of which, what happens is now giving error actually. So if that is now given, receiving inspection account has not been set because of which, what happens, you are unable to see it. Otherwise, what happens, the journal entries will be coming. Again, what happens, your partial journal entry has already come now. But since the receiving inspection account has not been set here, what happens, it is not showing anything now. So that is the reason that it is not showing. So once when that is set, what happens, it will be showing you the complete one. So this completes a small demo of what happens right from item creation up to what happens to pushing it into invoicing, as well as what happens pushing into costing also. So the system is basically what is really very excellent actually when compared to e-business. So many things have been what happens. The cumbersome has been reduced, and then what happens, it is now made, the process is more simple, and then it has been made more powerful also. So powerful is also added now. So if you have any specific questions on this, you can very well ask me.
Just Nana, like as part of training, like you started creating item. So yeah. Will you also be explaining the master control attributes, child control attributes?
No, that will be explained in the inventory training actually.
Inventory.
So this is the procurement training, and so what happens, we will not be controlling what exactly is controlled at master level, which is at the org level, and then what is the serial control, lot control, revision control, locator control, material status control, all these things will be controlled in the inventory training.
Okay.
So this will be concentrating. I'll not tell you what exactly is the agenda for this training.
Yeah.
Go there.
See, this training, you know, he just showed you what are all the org structure has been already created with the help of that. Yeah. He showed you that item and other things, right? During the procurement training, he will create a full enterprise structure, not in vision. With the help of that, all the setups will be explained. So that is more easy to, instead of using like a vision, right? So you are also can create your own structure. In that, you can create an item. In that, you can create your like a receiving or P2P process, etc. So yep. That is the advantages of manager training. Okay.
This is the agenda for this training actually. So introduction to the enterprise structure will be made. Then what happens will be showing you all these things now. We'll now start to create from locations, the legal jurisdictions, the legal authorities, the legal address, then the legal entity itself will be created now. So you will know how the managed chart of accounts will be created. COA will be set now. The primary ledger will be created. So a skeleton financial setup will be made ready. And okay. Upon which what happens, we will be creating the business unit now. And then afterwards, the inventory setups will be done. Afterwards, the HRMS setups will be done. And then afterwards, we'll now land upon what happens, your procurement setups. So once when everything is now done, what happens, we'll now do the financial options and purchasing options. And finally, what happens, we'll now create an item creation. And then afterwards, what happens, we'll now create the purchase acquisition. And then afterwards, we'll now do other activities as such. Purchase orders, automatic purchase orders, everything will be shown to you. And then afterwards, what happens, the receiving activities, all the fully will be explained. And then the payables options, we'll now push it into payables for invoice creations. So likewise, what happens, the debit number, or retroactive pricing, consigned inventory, everything will be done. The costing will be fully set, and then it will be shown to you. And then what happens, the demo process, and then data migration also. So here in the eBiz, what happens, migrating the data is a responsibility of the technical team. Now here what happens, everything is in the functional side. The functional team only has to do everything. So that will also be fully taught in this training.
And you'll be sharing this instance link, Nana, okay, right?
The instance link will be given to you, and then what happens, you can very well practice on this instance link. It's a release to an instance. And then unfortunately, what happens, this customer has purchased only purchasing, and so the other pillars of purchasing will not work, like sourcing, iSupply portal, and then supplier quality, etc. will not work. The order management also will not work. So only pure procurement only will work now. Fine. This training is only pure procurement. So the duration expected is approximately 25 to 30 hours, depending upon the discussion actually. And then what happens, you will be having a complete, what happens, end-to-end, what happens, an implementation experience on this.
Mostly it will be on the functional side only, right?
Of course. It will be purely only on the functional side, not on technical side.
And what will be the timings for this training?
Yeah.
Like 25 hours every day or?
No. It's on a Saturday and Sunday, basically. I'll show you the timings. The timings. I will take a copy of it. One second, I'll stop sharing now. Let me come. And I'll not waste it in this place now. I will paste the timings now. So as per the IST, I'm pasting the timing now.
Okay.
So you can see the timings now.
It's okay.
Saturday and Sunday, 8:30 a.m. to 10 a.m. the first session. And then afterwards, what happens? 5:30 p.m. to 6:45. Then afterwards, the coffee break. And then 7 p.m. to 8:15. Again, a dinner break. And then from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. So it's on every Saturday and Sunday.
So Nana, if it is 5:30 p.m. IST, so for EST it will be 7 a.m. right?
7 a.m. of course. In the EST it will be 7 a.m.
So for me, tomorrow night and day after tomorrow morning, Sunday morning. Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay.
For Eastern people, what happens is that tomorrow night is the start time, and then day after tomorrow morning, it will be continuing. Okay.
I mean, it's okay. So 8:30 to 10 is on Saturday, and 5:30 p.m. to 6:45 on Sunday. 5:30 to 8:50.
Everything is on Sunday only for you. Fine. There is no activity on Saturday as such. No. Fine.
Oh.
Today is Saturday in India, and then what happens? We don't have any session in the evening actually. So tomorrow morning only it's going to begin now. Sunday morning 8:30 a.m. it's beginning.
Okay.
Fine. It's beginning on Sunday morning. So this training only for today. What happens? It has been postponed now. And then it is now going to begin tomorrow morning. And then from next week onwards, it will be on every Saturday and Sunday.
Okay.
And you have 5 days time to what happens, practice the entire session actually.
Yes. But how, I mean, for that practice, do we need to download anything on our computer?
I will give you all the documentation to you. And then the instance will be given to you. It's a web instance and so what happens, nothing to download. And then what happens, you have to fine-tune your browsers basically. Browsers has to be fine-tuned. And then that needs to work up all. Only what happens.
And for enrollment?
Yeah, the course fee is 3,000 rupees. I will now, all of you might have sent your email on a private chat to me. Okay, fine. I will now take it up and send this record also to you. Along with it, the course fee and then my bank details will be given to you. Fine. You make a payment today. And then as soon as I receive the payment, whatever, I'll be giving you the joining link for tomorrow. Actually.
Okay.
Joining will be in a different link. I'll be giving it to you. Any other doubts for anybody?
Yeah, no, I think you will be sharing the recordings for the rest of the classes. Only for demo you will be sharing.
Oh, it's very difficult because what happens, 25 hours of speech, you cannot remember at all. Fine. So I will be giving you recordings. My only what happens, a request to all of you is what you keep it with you because it's a commercial program and it is a low cost program. And so please do not share with others. As a Guru Dakshina, what happens, you refer your friends to me. Which help I want it now. Fine. I'm helping you with the recording and then you help me with this.
Sure.
So, I'm just a little bit confused with the timing again. See, for the EST guys, so for the next week, again, we'll be having Saturday night and Sunday morning. So,
no, is that the way it's going to work? Next week, what happens is on a Friday night for you.
Okay.
Friday night, 10 p.m. is the first session of the EST guys. Fine. And then afterwards, Saturday morning at 7 a.m.
Okay. And Sunday morning again?
Again. The same thing will be repeating on the next day.
Sunday also?
Yeah. Friday night and Saturday morning. And then Saturday night and Sunday morning.
Oh, okay.
Everybody listen. Actually, this timing is given only for tomorrow, Sunday. But normally for Saturday as well as Sunday morning and evening. Is it clear?
Okay.
For Indian time.
Normally, Indian time. Indian time is morning and evening. Fine. And then for the Eastern time zones people, what happens is the previous day, one session in the night and then afterwards the next day morning. Those who are sitting in Eastern time, what happens from the next week onwards, Friday night, 10 p.m. one session, and then Saturday morning, 7 a.m. the next session starts.
And Sunday same way, right?
Sunday same.
Okay.
That's why four session and Saturday, Sundays. Is it clear?
And every session, what happens, I will tell you when the session is going to start, so you won't be getting confused.
Okay.
So now for tomorrow in India, tomorrow it will be at 8:30 in the morning.
Of course, naturally.
10 o'clock.
Yeah.
And in the evening also, once again, there will be another session.
Three sessions in the evening from 5:30 onwards, three sessions.
No. He is asking whether it's going to start around evening 5:30 p.m. or not tomorrow.
Today, there is no session at all. Today, there
tomorrow,
is.
Tomorrow.
It is going to begin only tomorrow morning at 8:30 a.m.
8:30, one session. And then in the evening, remaining sessions.
Remaining session, the evening.
Okay, thank you.
Similarly, for all Saturdays and days.
Of course.
Right.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me. Yeah.
Nana, sir, a request from my side.
Yeah, tell me. Yeah.
I mean, the pace or the way, if you can a bit slower, like it would be.
This is only a simple run through of the complete cycle. So what happens, I'm going through fast. Everything will be fully explained. Right? Not that what happens, I'll be.
Yeah, actually, I agree with the other gentleman.
Yeah. Each and every setup will be fully explained. Right?
I will because I am not very familiar with the EBS also. I mean, I'm just getting into it.
See, everything.
No worry. Anyway, he is going to give a recording, right? You can run through and you can do the practice remaining 5 days, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
Everything will be fully explained. Not that what happens, I'll be just skipping through each and everything. Everything will be explained to you on the menu.
Yeah. And one more request also, like, I mean, when you discuss something or when you're explaining something, if you can explain with slower pace, that would be actually when you are actually, when, by the way, when the way you explain, bit faster. So it would be, if you can slow the pace, then people would be able to follow you.
Okay, then yeah, I will try my level best, because what happens is a huge program, and then if you slow it down, what happens, we cannot come 25 hours, it will go to even 50 hours also. It will be becoming very difficult. So to a certain extent, what happens, I will not try to slow it down. But there will be a lot of explanations. My explanations will be huge. So what happens,
No, that I understand. The way you talk, and I mean, it will be a fast, right? So sometimes actually, I mean, to follow you, it will be difficult.
My only request is what? Whenever you are not understanding and then you want a clarification, you ask me to repeat, I will know definitely.
Okay, sure.
Fine. That way, what happens, you will understand it.
Okay. And one more thing also, when, like, when you explain the transaction,
yeah,
will you be in a position to correlate some technical part, like base minimum?
No, I don't know technical.
Only functional things only you be.
Yeah, well, we're explaining only, right? Functionals actually.
Oh, okay.
Because we want to know what are the tables you're sitting, something, some basic information, Nana. What are the tables?
I know idea at all. Where to see the tables and all, I don't know idea at all. Otherwise, whatever.
So you have Toad access and all, Nana?
No, Toad, you cannot access this instance via Toad actually. Fine. It is basically web, is a Java based fine ADF technology.
Yeah, I mean, I understand the database access we don't have. Yeah, I mean, cloud, I mean, R12 we have access, but.
Here, what happens, I will not tell you where exactly, which table name and all. I will now give you everything. Fine. Complete table names of each and every module will be given to you, and then all the user guides and implementation guides of all the modules will be given to you. How to make the OTBA reports, everything will be given to you. So from the technical perspective, you will be having a lot of inputs, but what happens, since I don't know anything, I will not be able to do any big
Nana, after completing this course, can we go ahead for certification?
Of course. What happens if you're in Madras, what happens, I have even a way to pass the exam also. I will be giving you dumps also. And then what happens, the dumps, around 70 to 80% are coming from the dumps. That is what the students are saying. But there are institutes which will help you pass also.
So, yeah.
I don't know whether there is in Hyderabad. It must be definitely.
No, in Hyderabad also, we have the institutes. But basically, by listening to your training, I think, can we go ahead without the institute help, or we need again?
No. Actually, you have to do one practice. Then only you can go for examination. That is the best practice. That's it.
Yeah, thanks, Vaskaran.
Of course, yeah. For any exam, you need to do practice. So.
Absolutely. See, it is not only for the marks point of view, right?
Right. From learning perspective also, just for the satisfaction in the practical life, actually, you should know what to do.
Exactly.
Dumps and all, it is called to support to get your more marks. But originally, you should evaluate with the help of the practice and knowledge. Correct? That is very important.
Yeah, that is more important. Yeah.
Yeah, Nana, this is Gopal. So how many sessions is going to take for to cover the
I normally expect 6 days now, but what happens if the interactions are more, it may even be more. 6 days means 3 weekends actually, but now it's beginning on Sunday, right? Sunday onwards we can say 6 days, but I hope that it must be completed, but let us see how it's going. If interactions are more, what happens if we may even have to go for the 7th day also.
Yeah, it might get extra.
So you're going to provide the complete documentation, right? Including the technical stuff as well.
Complete documentation will be given to you. The user guides, the implementation guides, my prepared documentation, as well as what happens, everything will be given to you. My worksheets. So you need not have to worry anything at all about it. Even the dumps will be given to you.
Okay. And Nana, like one more request. Like after this training also, if we find any questions or anything, can we touch it?
Yeah. I'm even supporting my students. In fact, what happens, three of the projects, what happens, I'm supporting them. And then what happens, they go live.
Through the mail, you can reach in. That is the best to practice instead of
Yeah, I have my, you can know my WhatsApp number, my Skype number. And then what happens, I know in US, I'll be in US up to July. And then I will now come back to Madras. So you can always contact me. And then what happens, I will now friendly help you out when you're stuck.
Sure. Thank you.
No, no, after this iProcurement training, are you going to cover this SCM?
No, I don't know iProcurement because I have learned only procurement and then I have implemented this. The remaining pillars are not known to me. I have to only learn actually.
SCM, okay.
Pressure like you.
But Nana, you have some plans on inventory and order management, right?
Yeah, I'm not going to, what happens, practice inventory and then maybe by mid of March, I'm planning to start inventory. And then afterwards, mid of April, I'm planning to start order management. Let me hope that what happens, I'll be able to do this. And I'm not very sure what it might. Let me.
So, Nana, when you did implementation, that was from EBS to...
No. Not from EBS. It's a fresh customer. And then what happens, it's a bakery customer, FMCG company. And so we did an implementation directly. It's a very simple one. So what happened? It was not having much of a challenge actually. And then one more thing, a telecom company. So both the implementations are really fairly simple. And so what happens, we could do it very fast. And then here, even the implementation life cycle is also very, very fast when compared to EBS basically.
EBS, yeah.
Every future of EBS has not come. Fine. It is now coming. And then within a year or two, what happens, it will be surpassing EBS. That is what the plan, that is what the proposal is.
In that case, all this thing will go, Nana, this other ERP technologies like Siebel, JD Edwards, everything they will replace?
That is a plan. Basically, what happens, they want to have only one platform of what happens, Fusion. Down the line, what happens, if you see, after 5 years' time, what happens, they'll be having only Fusion over there. So that is what the plan is. So already they have incorporated the PeopleSoft features over here now, JD Edwards features, every feature has been brought on over here now. So Fusion is nothing but an amalgamation of all the bot products of Oracle into one platform actually.
So they clubbed all the functionalities of other ERPs and clubbed into Oracle.
Already, they already done it.
With your experience, how long it will take to do an implementation?
Yeah, we can do an implementation within 3 months' time actually. Yeah, reasonable size, fine. If it's a really large size, then what happens, it will be very difficult. So many operating units, so many this thing are there, then it will be big. But a simple company, what happens, we can very well do it in about 3 months.
On the technical perspective, we'll be having much work or it's more of function?
Technical, as of now, what happens, they don't have much of a work other than preparing the reports in the company now. Now, what happens from release 13 onwards, what happens, an on-premise version is also coming. Till now, what happens, everything is cloud now. So, release 13 will be having an on-premise version as well as a cloud version. In both the cases, what happens, they are now planning to open up some arena for technical to do some activity. As of now, what happens, the technical do not have much of an activity at all. Now, what happens, it's now getting opened up in this time.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, Nana, when are you going to plan for the next batch? You know, I'm not sure whether I can make it for the current batch or not.
No idea at all. Fine. As of now, what happens, because of Muthu and Mukesh, what happens, we suddenly launched this program. So, if some guys, what happens, they express their interest, then naturally, what happens, we'll be having the program. So it all depends upon a need basis, basically. Fine. If something comes up, what happens?
Okay.
You can talk to Yogi, and then what happens? You can even if you can form a batch, what happens? We can do it now. Fine.
Thank you for arranging the session on behalf of
us. So we'll now meet at 8:30 a.m. Sunday morning. Fine. Please make the payments as soon as possible. We'll be sending all the payment links and things to you in about half an hour.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Yeah, I will be here for some more time for what happens. I will not see whether anybody is joining or not. Others who have completed, they can even leave the meeting on the bottom. Okay.
Okay.
Bye for all of you. I will not start recording now. I'm not recording this. I'm
stopping. Bye-bye.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you, sir. Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.